If you're watching this video, you're probably a huge fan of anime yourself. However, have you ever wondered how much effort it actually takes to produce what you're seeing on screen? Welcome to Broken Obsessed, and today we'll be presenting you with our analysis of how anime is created. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel and turn on notifications for more videos like this one. Without further ado, let's begin. Japanese animation is one of the most renowned film arts in the world, at least in my heart. With every passing year, animation technology becomes much more complex and developed, as we can see from the art style changes, some of the best anime that we've seen in years. So, to learn how anime is created today, and why the current process is the one being used by the animation companies, we need to learn a little bit about its backstory first. The first anime was created by Junichi Kochi, a Japanese animator known as one of the fathers of anime. He produced Namakura Gatana, Chamibo Kukijono, Haniwa Hakunai, Kappa Matsuri, and spawned a whole production process of animation that eventually would take inspiration from Disney's own animation scene. Turns out that the first anime from Japan was actually a short and a silent film created by Junichi. Kochi had created it by using cutout animation characters, a form of stop motion animation that employed flat characters created from card or stiff fabric. Shikara to Ono no Yananaka was the first animation to use voices in 1932. It was by this moment that artists from both France and the USA picked up the art. It was originally believed that animations couldn't be used to tell long stories due to their unpopularity, their expensive nature, and their sheer amount of time consumed in making them. On top of that, Japanese anime remained silent for quite a long time in black and white, but Western animations had already moved to sound and color and eclipsed it in almost every known way. This served as a wake-up call for the anime Disney, and unlike what most people know, Disney had a pretty heavy influence on anime, with some of the most renowned creators such as Osamu Tezuka admitting that he grew up watching Disney films. From there, he grew to the passion to pursue the art, borrowing some features from Disney such as large eyes and round childlike features, something that stuck with anime to date. A few examples would include Adventure Time, which is a popular American animated sitcom, and JoJo, a popular Japanese action anime known for its complex and detailed character expressions. A few years down the road, we have Adobe Animate, a program that made sketching to inking possible on the computer, and in a minimal amount of time, no less. To better compare the technology shift in anime, we need to compare two anime films that best represent it, one from 1988 and one from 2017. Let's begin with The Legend of the one more time. Also known as The Legend of the Galactic Heroes. There we go. An OVA film produced from 1988 to 1997 by Kitty Films with 110 episodes and based on a series of 10 novels by Yoshiko Tanaka. In America, Japanese anime flourished more than the first screening of Space Battleship Yamato, The Final Chapter, an animation film from Japan in Baltimore at the World Science Fiction Convention Visual K, is a Japanese pop culture that has been influenced by animation. It began in the 1980s and incorporates a visual style of cross-dressing as females among male band members. Some of the bands that use key Visual K concepts are Penicillin, X-Japan, and Malice Mizer. I probably mispronounced that, but let's continue. It's a culture influenced by goth and punk, and sometimes has metal and classical elements fused with Japanese pop. Now, one of the main concerns with anime is that many of the animators behind the scenes are actually broke and facing work conditions that can end up burning them out very, very easily. Have you ever seen the infamous "how many hours does a mangaka sleep" memes during their schedules? A mangaka probably sleeps around 20 hours a week as they have to spend time drawing, storyboarding, planning, drafting, editing, and then an animator has to do the same job in a different compartment. On top of that, anime is almost entirely drawn by hand, and given the amount of frames an animation possesses, it takes a lot of skill to create a hand-drawn animation and to do it quickly. For example, Shingo Adaichi, the character designer and animator for SAO or Sword Art Online, said that with nearly 200 animated TV series alone made in Japan every year, there aren't just enough people with the skill or the willpower to work as an animator. Studios have to rely on a wide array of unpaid freelancers who are passionate about drawing and illustrating, which is kinda terrible when you think of it. At the entry level, we have in-between animators, who tend to be the freelancers. These are the ones who make individual drawings after the top-level directors come up with the storyboards and the key animators draw the important frames in every scene. So, just like Western animation, anime has to incorporate a fully-fledged team of workers and creators to create the magic behind every single frame and scene that we see. However, unlike Western animation companies like Disney, their working conditions aren't exactly top-notch. I mean, Disney is also infamous for its slave labor-like working conditions for employers and resorts, but even then, they have good standards for animators and other workers who create the magic, or at least good when compared with that of animation companies. On top of that, anime has even more meticulous attention to detail than other types of animation, which are usually ignored by Western animation. This includes food, architecture, and landscape, of which objects take 5 times even more time, effort, and planning to properly draw. Working conditions tend to be really grim. Animators tend to fall asleep at their desks, and some even end up hospitalized multiple times due to illness, such as Henry Thurlow, an American animator living and working in Japan. On top of that, anime takes way too long to make. It's meticulous, with just one cut and one scene taking 3 to 4 animators working on it. But just so everybody knows, I still appreciate all the work they put into one of my favorite mediums. Animators do what they can to survive, and most of the time, they are overworked because they have to take care of their families while also holding a side hustle. At least, computer animation has been a big relief for animators worldwide. Their working conditions still kinda suck, but things are much easier now. There's a belief that the best animators are those that have been trained on the hand-drawing method. The faster an artist is at drawing an animation, the better. Thus, what he decides to use to achieve the best results should not be an issue. All modern films use computer technology, but a substantial amount of film are still made handmade. Animators have the task of imagining designs for, let us say, buildings in the film, as well as the environment around the house. Computers are just used to fine-tune the details of these designs, improving the quality of films, allowing for more high-quality scenes and audio-visual content than that of a few years back. So, what are your guys' thoughts on the anime creation process? Let me know in the comments. Also, don't forget to leave us a like, share this video with your friends, and subscribe to Broken Obsessed for more videos like this one. I hope you enjoyed it. I've been Broken Obsessed in my otaku ways, and I will see all of you next time.